So I will take 4-hour chart to take profit, right? Or in this 1-hour chart, it was beautiful downtrend, right? Let's say you place a sell anywhere in between, right? Like here, for example. Well, any place is okay. Let's say you place a sell after the breakout of this recent low downwards here. And you keep holding this sell, and you are actually basically following this 1-hour bearish trend. So first, initially my stop loss was on this recent high up here, and as I see the market is starting to going down, and as I see the market is running like 20 or 30 pips of profit, I move this stop loss to break even line, which is exactly below this position, so that now it becomes win or break even game, and the price keeps going down. And in this case, right, it's like going opposite way, right? Because in this 1-hour chart, you see Kijun Sen is moving down, and also Kumo, Senko Span A and B is moving down. So as long as the Senko Span A is moving down and B is moving down, I don't take profit. So the very first time that I might be thinking about taking profit is maybe here, right? When I see Senko Span B become flat and also Senko Span A becomes flat too. This is when I start to think about taking profit, which is happening exactly here, because that means that the market is retracing. And when Senko Span A start to retrace like this way, like going backwards, that means market is retracing too. In this bearish trend, whenever I see Senko Span A to be retracing, I will be thinking about taking profit. So, and after that, well, actually, as a result, it didn't break the recent high upwards like this way, but instead it went downwards. So most likely I will be keep holding this sell. And after I see the breakout on this recent low downwards to this way, I move this break-even line to slightly above the recent high, which is here, so that I ensure this amount of pips, right, of 284 pips of profit, I ensure it, and I keep extending that profit, right? So this is going to be my take profit line, but I don't take profit manually in this case. I just move this break-even line to slightly above the recent high and ensure about 280 pips of profit, and I keep watching the market, right? And after that, the price went all the way down, and now it's retracing backwards. So the very first time, right? So the next time, right? So the very first time that I think about taking profit is here, right? And afterwards, the next timing that I will be thinking about taking profit is again when the Senko Span A start to retrace backwards like this way. And also when the first time when I see Kijun Sen to be moving up, this is somewhere that I'm thinking about taking profit too. Because when you see the downtrend, right, when you see its downtrend, Kijun Sen never go upwards, right? It becomes horizontal, right? Kijun Sen becomes horizontal, or Kijun Sen goes down, but it never goes upwards, as you can see. So whenever you see Kijun Sen to go backwards against the major trend, the first time, this is something different, right? And this is where market is losing its momentum of this bearish trend. This is exactly somewhere that I'm thinking about taking profit. And also when I see Senko Span A retracement like this way, I will be thinking about taking profit here. And finally, if the candlestick breaks this Kijun Sen upwards and also gets into the Kumo, I will be taking profit for sure. This is going to be where I take profit. You see, this is buy and this is the stop loss, right? I move the stop loss to below this position, below this, sorry, so it was sell. So I place a sell here, place a sell, and my TP or SL, I move this SL to slightly above this recent high so that I ensure this amount of profit, and I keep running the profit, right? And here, the market retraced backwards, so I take profit already, right? Whenever the price gets inside the Kumo, I take profit. So usually I take profit manually, right? Some people, right, take profit automatically. They already preset the take profit line and they take profit manually. But to me, I don't do that. I always take profit manually by looking at the momentum of the market. And I don't look at the lower time frames to take profit. I only look at the bigger time frames, like 1 hour or 4 hour or daily chart to take profit. Depending on which time frame I see the trend, I take profit accordingly on that time frame. So in this case, in this 1 hour chart was downtrend, so I take profit according to downtrend, this 1 hour chart. And like I said, when Kijun Sen first went upwards, I think about taking profit. And also when I see, in addition to that, when I see Senkou Span A to be retracing, this is another point that I take profit. And when the candlestick went inside the Kumo, then this is exactly where I take profit. In this case, the price broke the recent high upwards. So this is another great take profit timing, because now this is going upwards. Right now, the market switched to the uptrend after confirming this recent breakout to the upside. Because as long as the trend persists downside, it never breaks the recent high upwards. But now it broke upwards here. So I can see that this is the end of the downtrend for now. It might persist, right? It may persist downside after this, but we never know. All we know is that we know that, you know, and here when you see the recent high breakout, we know that this downtrend is now ended. And now you see the Kumo twist, right? So the Kumo twist can be another confirmation to take profit too. When I see the Kumo twist, for sure I will take profit. But right, I don't take profit manually. I take profit manually, and I don't take profit automatically. And this is how I keep extending the profit as long as possible. So like in this Euro pound too. Like in this Euro pound, oh now it's taking profit, right? As you can see, I was buying it here. I was buying it here, and now we observed that the position is taking profit here, exactly. And that's because the price is now coming all the way down and broke the recent low downwards. And this is going to be the beginning of this downtrend. It may persist to the downtrend now. And that's why it's reasonable to put to move the stop loss to this line, to this price level, so that you can ensure this amount of profit, and you can still look for keep holding this position here. Yeah, and also one of these positions was actually taking price. Actually, I took the other one here actually. When I see the breakout of the recent low downwards, I took the other position here, and now this is taken automatically here. And I don't have any positions on this Euro pound now. But yeah, in this way, you can first be playing the game of win or break even, and later, right? Later you can run profit, right? You run profit, and you can be either win or more win gains by trading the profit in that way. Do you trade stocks and shares of company? I don't take trades on stocks actually. I am purely focused on Forex, and I don't trade Bitcoins or any cryptos either. Yeah, Forex, in especially these main pairs are the ones that I only trace. But from this year, I'm thinking to start trading on the stocks, but now the market has crashed, so I'm not sure. I'm not sure this year I will be touching on the stocks or not. But I started to study about stocks too. Alright, so this is uptrend right now. Still uptrend on this pound, Euro pound. So let's take a look at even the bigger time frames now. Right, so in this 4 hour chart too, right, when you look at it in this 4 hour, before it was moving up, right? Before it was moving up, but now I see multiple reasons that this is the end of the uptrend. I see multiple reasons why this is the end of the uptrend, right? Do you know what are the confirmations of for this is the end of the uptrend potentially? Let me just ask you a question now. So I can see that this is the end of the uptrend for a few reasons. Yeah, maybe for some people this is the uptrend, but to me this is the end of the down, the end of the uptrend. So let me just ask you. Yeah, what do you think about this market right now? Again, we're looking at this ERGBP 4-hour chart. Let me just write it down here. ERGBP 4-hour chart. Yeah, I wouldn't look for the buy chance in this case by looking at this 4-hour chart. You know, price action wise, this is uptrend still. Still, the lows are getting higher, and I can see there's a trend line, right? There's a trend line like this way. So price action wise, this is the uptrend, but it's just ended for now. Single span A, single span B coming together. Sure. All right. It's getting closer now. Right. So is it time to sell ERGBP KSI? No. You have to hold. You have to wait for next confirmation of up or downtrend. Right, so again, you know, because I see this is the end of the uptrend, I don't say that it's gonna go down, right? It might consolidate for a while, or it may continue to be moving up. But I can see that this is, for now, the end of this uptrend. Tenkan-sen Kijun-sen may dead cross, sure. Yeah, that will be another confirmation. Tenkan-sen Kijun-sen dead cross. Kijun-sen back down. Sure, Kijun-sen is still moving up, basically. The green one is Kijun-sen, and this is still moving up. Bad cross, alright, bad cross. Dead cross, right? Tenkan-sen, Kijun-sen, dead cross here. Tenkan-sen, Kijun-sen, crossover, Chikou is crossing down. Price fell below Senkospan B flat line. Yep, that will be the confirmation too. So, yeah, Tenkan-sen, Kijun-sen, crossover here. And Chikou-span is slightly touching on these candles. Right, so this also shows that it's losing buying energy now. When you see Chikou span to be touching on these candles, this is showing that this is right. The uptrend is now getting weaker. So here too, when you see Chikou span to be interacting with these candles, this means that the uptrend is getting weaker now. So we better wait for the breakout, basically, right? Wait for the breakout and expect the market to be moving that way. Alright, Chikou span closed below recent high. Recent high is here, right? So now Chikou span is actually going backwards to the candles, and it's almost crossing, dead crossing downwards now. Kijun Sen pointing down, price breaks recent low. Senko span A pointing down. Yeah, so Kijun Sen is still moving up technically, because this green one is the Kijun Sen. Slightly moving up. But I can see that Senko span A is moving downwards now. High is getting close to Kumo. Senko span A moved down. Yep, exactly. So high getting closer and closer to Kumo is another confirmation. When you see the market to be moving up momentarily, but goes downwards this way, then the high is even getting closer and closer to Kumo, right? So that means that this is losing its uptrend now. Senko span A, Kumo is turned down, exactly. To summarize it, right? First, I see first Kijun's Senko span B flat, right? Senko span B flat, and also Kijun. I keep saying Kijun-sen for some reason. Senko span A is retracing backwards now, right? Rolling over now. So this shows that this may be the end of the uptrend. And also Tenkan-sen Kijun-sen dead cross is another reason, right? Because whenever you see Tenkan-sen Kijun-sen dead cross, right, it also shows that this may be the end of the uptrend, right? We better be careful for this retracement. So right now we see that this is dead crossing, so we can say that it may keep going downwards this way. And also Chikou span is breaking these candles downwards, so these are like multiple confirmations for this uptrend to be ending. And that's why I wouldn't look for the buy chance in this case. Yeah, that's why I don't look for the buy chance. In this case, I will just stay away from this pair. And also, just in case, by looking at this daily chart too, right, Kumo is spiking up. And this is too thin, right? This is too thin. So I don't want to take this daily Kumo as uptrend because the Kumo is too thin. And in fact, it's retracing backwards, right? So whenever you see thin Kumo like this, there is higher possibility for the price, for the market to be retracing backwards. And that's why you don't want to take this thin Kumo here. When it's moving up, the Kumo should be thick enough and thick and long enough, right? But right now this is too thin, so the price might retrace backwards. It might retrace backwards even more because Kumo is thin here. And that's why I was taking trades based on the 4-hour chart when I was taking buy here, because I saw that Kumo has been going up and long enough, and Senko Span B was moving up and Kijun Sen was moving up too at that time, and that's why I took a buy. When the price breaks the Kumo downward, is it the great take profit level if I buy? Kumo downtrend, the price breaks the Kumo downtrend. Sometimes, right, a Kumo is very slow in terms of the signal, so maybe you can take profit even before that. There are many situations in the market. So if I take the example here, in this case, like 1-hour chart, when I will be taking profit will be I am again expecting the price to be breaking upwards this way. So if not, then I will just end up with break even or some amount of profit, and it's alright to me. But to take profit right now, I will keep looking at this Senko Span A, and whenever it's going backwards, I think about taking profit. And also whenever I see Kijun Sen to move downwards, then also I will be thinking about taking profit. So yeah, before, right, earlier after I took a buy, there was a retracement in Senko Span A, but here I wasn't able to watch the market because I was doing 101 session right before, until right before this live stream started. So I wasn't looking at the chart and I wasn't able to look at this Senko Span A retracement. And eventually, right, it's going upwards now. So yeah, right now for me, I'm still holding this buy. So yeah, and also Kijun Sen, right? Whenever I see Kijun Sen to be pointing downwards next time, I might be thinking about taking profit. So yeah, if you wait enough, right, if you wait until the price to be breaking the Kumo downwards, right, in this case it's gonna be here, so this is gonna be too late to take that profit. So depending on where you buy, the take profit timing is going to be different. If you're taking buy here, maybe you can wait for the Kumo breakout and also Kumo twist to the bearish Kumo and you take profit here. But if you're placing the buy like I do right here, you cannot wait until the price breaks the Kumo downwards because this is going to be too late. So yeah, it depending on where you take buy or where you take sell, the take profit timing is going to be changed. So yeah, this has been quite strong uptrend now. So yeah, there's no reason for me to take that profit yet. Right now I see that there is a recent high, it's getting lower here. So if the price keeps going down from here and if it goes upwards, but afterwards it keeps going down even and breaks this recent low even downwards, then probably I will be taking that profit even before it touches on this break even. And if I were to able watch the market at that timing, I might be taking profit here with some amount of profit. And in that case, this Kijun Sen should be downwards too, right? Because the lows, the highs are getting lower and lower here. So Kijun Sen should be pointing downwards too. So that also confirms me to take profit. after this recent low breaking downwards. So that's my take profit strategy. Or I placed a break even line here already, so I can just leave the chart and probably come back to the chart tomorrow and see how it played out. Maybe it's gonna break it down upwards from here too. And in that case, again, right, like I said, I will move the stop loss to slightly below the recent low in lower time frame. Yeah, if I see the breakout to the upside to this way in 1 hour chart, then I will be moving this stop loss or break even line to slightly below this wick pointing downwards, so that I can ensure this amount of profit, right, of like a 62 pips of profit. And I will expect the price to be going even farther up in this case. Yeah, for now these lines are actually on the break-even line here. Thank you for watching the video until the end. As you may have already known, I run an Ichimoku community, and here is a list of the perks that you can expect. I have these perks as of April 2020, like Ichimoku Basic Masterbook, members only lives 3 times a week, and Ichimoku Discord, members only Q&A session, Ichimoku quizzes, and original emojis and badges that you can use on this YouTube channel. But I am thinking to add more and more perks to this membership community, because this is a paid service and I don't want you to waste your time and money on this. As a Japanese trader, it's been such a pleasure to be able to share the beauty of Ichimoku Kinkohyo, and I will continue to try my best to share the knowledge and wisdom with you based on my own experience. So if this is something that you're interested in, you can always join this Ichimoku community by clicking a join button on the YouTube or by accessing to a link on the description below. I will be waiting for you on the membership lives and Discord, and hope you to continue to build up more Ichimoku knowledge. I wish you a great success on your trading journey, and I will see you on the next lives or videos. Thank you for your support as always, and stay gold!